Greetings, OPPO community, and welcome to our last tool, Strategic Orientations and Planning for Action. As you will have received the tool in a format that you can go through in detail, we will explain you this tool step by step and how the whole OPPO cycle comes to a closing through this last tool. So the aim of the tool is to integrate the outcomes of the different tools that we have been explaining to you in other sessions and to identify the really critical challenges and opportunities according to the six OPPO intervention areas and to select the key issues that you can address. So at the end, you will define an outcome and plan of activities for key issues that are being retained. So from all the key issues, you're choosing specific ones that you're going to address. For whom and why? So it's not only for farmers and farmer organizations, but also SMEs, companies, and processors and traders that want to work together with farmers and their organizations, and also other stakeholders in support of the performance of farmers' organizations and to support livelihoods and rural development. But for the farmers and their organizations is of specific importance because they are going to be the ones who will really need to know the ins and outs and where they want to go, so all the other actors can support them. When are you using this? So you're ready to use this tool when you have reviewed the other OPPO tools and you have really understood well your farmer inclusive agri-economic development case. And when you really want to move to action. Now you're ready to go and implement your case. So ideally you have already utilized the other OPPO tools. And it will also help you to look at the OPPO tools from a different angle. So just a recap of the approach. We have first introduced the case description and baseline where you have been collecting the basic information. Then we have moved to the farmers themselves, profiling them and how they can best mobilize their own resources. Then we have looked at farmer organizations, assessing the governance, management, and performance of organizations. And then in the last two webinars, we have discussed the subsector and value chain analysis and mapping, as well as the importance of the stakeholder market system mapping. So now we're going to move further and closing the OPPO cycle and looking at strategic orientations and planning. And therefore, you will be introduced to the six specific intervention areas and how you can really do your planning. And more to that from Ted now.
Hello, Pacific. So today we go from the green to the red and the blue. So that's a special day today. If everything is well, we have been working with some of the six green tools, as Jana explained. And then we relate it to the six OPPO intervention areas. And for most cases of agroeconomic development, you need to work on good agriculture practices. For good agriculture practices, you need inputs. And if farmers need to intensify the production, generally they need agri-finance. And with OPPO, we don't only look at the production side, we also look at the market side. So we have two more intervention areas, post-harvest value creation and market relations and sales. And with the last two tools, the value chain analysis and the stakeholder mapping, you have been looking at those. And in general, for farmers, we need policy change and a more enabling environment. So those are the six intervention areas which are going to be important today. Now, before we go, a small recap. With OPPO, we are working for farmer agency, the farmer empowerment. So we have five principles we would like to refresh to you now. The first is treat farmers as entrepreneurs, because that's what they really are. They are the largest part of the private sector. Ensure ownership of change processes right from the start. And that's why also we have these tools that started with farmers, to have farmers on board right from the start, and to have many perspectives from farmers with the different tools. You're working on practical cases, so we are not in theory, we are really looking at action. The fourth principle is organize agroeconomic development as a team sport. That's why specifically the tool of stakeholder mapping was important. And last but not least, but we put it in the last place, is align external support to plans of farmers themselves. So today we talk about strategic orientations and planning, which are the plans of the farmers in the first place, which are plans of farmers working together with other stakeholders. And after that, maybe international organizations may come in and give additional support to make these plans work better, faster, whatever. But it shouldn't be external parties that define the agenda. So those are the five important principles of OPPO, which are also particularly important when you come to action planning. Now, what we will be explaining today are three basic steps. The first is the identification of challenges and opportunities. And for that one, you can have been using six different tools. What we want to stress is that we offer a toolbox. You don't need to use all the tools all the time. You can make a choice out of them. But the more tools you use, the more different perspectives you will have harnessed. Then after this one, we go to planning. And Melike will explain the step-by-step approach to come to planning. It includes taking stock of all challenges and opportunities and strategizing. And last but not least is the formulation of outcomes, and we distinguish primary outcomes and intermediary outcomes, and then you move to action planning and really you come to activities to implement. So that will be the story of today. So the three steps are also shown in this figure. We will talk about the vision, and the vision is the faraway future, maybe 15, 20, 25 years from now. It's really your dream. As I explained, you need interventions in six different intervention areas. But the first step to do is to really identify all the challenges and opportunities based on the OPPO analytical tools, and then move to planning. So first I will talk about the first step, identification of challenges and opportunities. So we use the six OPPO analytical tools to do that, and we suggest you that the challenges and opportunities that are specifically identified with certain steps are linked to the six OPPO intervention areas. So that's the first step, and I will go now through the six different tools and to show how you can identify challenges and opportunities. So today, actually, we are doing a kind of recap of the whole process. It started already with the introduction of Jana. So the first tool that we introduced is really the description of your case. And it can serve as a baseline. And if now with planning you're going to develop your program proposal, you always need to have baseline data. So it's really important to have a good description of your case. And as you remember, probably, in the first part of this tool, you already defined the scope of your case, which is also very important for planning. So we talked about the three P's, product, place, and producers. So your case has a certain commodity focus, you work with a certain group or community of farmers, and you focus on a certain geographical area where the product is produced and the farmers live. Then the tool consisted of 10 chapters. So the next chapters, those were the chapters 4 to 8, they were linked to the six intervention areas. I will show that in detail later on. Chapter 9, we put it separately here, was on stakeholder roles and collaboration. And this is cross-cutting. So you will see that later on, for certain interventions, you need always to identify stakeholders with whom to collaborate. And then so at this stage, we suggest you to return to your case description and to review and update the information, because after applying the other tools, there's so much more information that you have collected, and to identify the main challenges and opportunities. this, I'm not going through all these points, but this shows how the different chapters of the case description were linked to the six intervention areas. So chapter 5 was related to agro inputs, chapter 6 was related to post-harvest value creation, etc. So there is a structure in this case description which is linked to the six intervention areas. Now you are able to link the different intervention areas to challenges and opportunities using your case description. So the first step is to identify challenges and opportunities based on your case description, and the basic format, which will be recurrent all the time, looks like this. So for agro inputs, what are the challenges? What are the opportunities? The same thing for agriculture practices. What are the challenges and opportunities? And finally, for the enabling environment, what did you identify as major challenges and opportunities? First step. Then the second tool was about farmer profiling. And here we really, because of the OPPO principles, we said, please go to farmers, go to their fields, talk to them, and make several profiles if you can. And then the farmers have been explaining their livelihoods to you. And for sure, they have mentioned many different challenges, and probably they have mentioned also some opportunities for change. So again, with the tool farmer profiling, you can identify challenges and opportunities linked to the six intervention areas. So if farmers said we don't have quality seeds, then definitely it's a challenge for agro inputs. If they say we only sell for a short period of time because we don't have storage facilities, it will be a challenge on the post-harvest value creation. So think of the challenges that are mentioned, think of the opportunities that are mentioned, and classify them according to the six intervention areas. Then the third tool, we hope you applied this one as well, the famous capital pentagon. There we looked at the resources that farmers have. The financial resources, the natural resources, physical, human and social. And then one of the outputs of this tool was not only the capital pentagon, the visualization of it, but also what is the current situation and what are options to strengthen the farmers' resources. So based on that one, you can make this first table. What are the challenges related to the five capitals and what are opportunities? Which can be transformed to this one, where the challenges and opportunities are linked to the six intervention areas. But here, there's a transition that is needed. Here are some examples. For instance, there's a human capital challenge, farmers' knowledge and skills to control pests and diseases. That's maybe what you identified. This has to do with agriculture production, so it can be put under agriculture practices. For natural capital, for instance, the challenge was that farmers do not have secure land rights. And then you can consider this as a production factor, so it can be put under agro inputs, or it can be put under enabling environment when it's a policy issue. Challenges related to financial capital are generally related to the intervention area agri-finance, not 100%, but most of the time. Physical capital is generally linked to production factors and agro inputs, so the first intervention area. Social capital, it's a complex one, a very important one. An example is, for instance, that farmers don't sell as a group, they sell individually. So there's a challenge of collective marketing, and that's an example of a challenge that can be put on the market relations and sales, for instance. Another example of social capital is, for instance, the weak governance and management of the farmer organization. So here, it's clearly about social capital. That's a choice that we suggest, that all the challenges and opportunities related to the governance and management of farmers' organizations is to be put under enabling environment. So farmers can create their own strong organizations, which will be then an enabling environment for them. So with that transition of social capital, of the five capital challenges opportunities, you can classify them again according to the six intervention areas. The fourth tool, we have six, so I'm halfway, is the GMP scoring. This one was focusing on the farmers organization. Then the output was assessment and scoring according to 16 dimensions, conclusions, and again the question what can or should be done to improve the situation. So here again you have many challenges and opportunities which can also be structured according to the intervention areas. And again, for the challenges and opportunities related to governance and management, we propose to put them under enabling environment. The fifth tool, that's a bit closer maybe in your memory, we did it some weeks ago, is the subsector and value chain mapping and analysis. You made the subsector map, and then many challenges and opportunities were identified, and probably these challenges and opportunities are most related to market relations and value creation. So those are the fourth and the fifth intervention area. But here again, you can classify the challenges and opportunities according to the six intervention areas. So somehow it is repetitive, but every different tool gives you different challenges and opportunities, and maybe sometimes gives you the same challenges and opportunities, which is in itself a kind of cross-checking of the importance of challenges and opportunities. The last one, introduced last week, it's the market system stakeholder mapping. There you have an overview of all the stakeholders. Remember the four categories: the value chain operators, the value chain supporters, enablers, and the fourth group of externally funded facilitators. We made a figure that looks like a hamburger. And the second step, actually maybe more important than the drawing itself, was again an analysis of the role and the strengths and the weaknesses of those stakeholders and what can be done to improve their roles and collaboration. So this was the output of the tool. What is identification of all the different stakeholders? What is the current situation? And what is the potential situation? Here again, we have to look at the different stakeholders and what is their role. Some examples of how to relate it later on to the different intervention areas. An example is, for instance, is that the role of research institutes is to breed and to develop varieties that are suitable for farmers in the production zone. If we talk about varieties, we talk about seeds, so it has to do with agro inputs. But the same research institute, they could do, for instance, market surveys. Then we propose that that role or that weakness, or whatever, is put under market relations and sales. A last example, government could play a role with food safety regulations. This could be important for post-harvest value creation, market relations and sales, and enabling environment. So the context also will define where to put it best, or maybe it's a challenge that has to be put in each of those three intervention areas. So the last table, again, looks the same, but with a different tool, what are the challenges and opportunities identified with the stakeholder mapping. The six tools are not the only tools you can use. There are so many others that you can use. And also you have a lot of experience with activities that are being implemented. For instance, you already are working on seed multiplication. Maybe you have already demonstration plots. What are the challenges and opportunities identified? Maybe you are used to work with problem and solution trees. If you have outcomes there, please use them as well for your strategizing and planning. SWOT analysis, we didn't really introduce it as an OPPO tool as such, but it is also a tool which is very good for analysis. If you have done it, please use the results also. So there are many other sources possible for identifying challenges and opportunities. So the aim of this very first step towards strategizing and planning is an identification of all challenges and opportunities with different tools and with different perspectives.